Some people are calling it the Great Recession as opposed to the Great Depression. It's been going on for how long?
2.5 years.
2.5 years or so. How, when do you think it's going to be over? Next month?
No, we're going to drop down the bottom of this thing for another 5 to 8 quarters at least.
How many people are out of work?
Where?
All over the country?
Well, 13% in California.
1 out of 10.
11 million people out of work?
Oh, no.
How long is it going to take to pull those people back to work? A while. You know, this is what's happening. People are losing ground. And this is what causes them to feel. They're afraid. And when they're afraid, they're pinching those pennies. And they're scared. And they're not going to buy much more than what they must have. Correct? I mean, you're all aware of this, and you're all probably making decisions like this on your own. There's some things in our house we might have bought, but we're putting off. Because we want to pinch those pennies for just a little while longer. On the other hand, my gold is going way up. So I'm happy with that. Okay. Making a good living on gold. So necessities only is what people are buying. True? Okay. Now, when someone goes over to Solar Hot or to Barry Smith or anybody and they say, we'd like you to give us a rough estimate of what it would cost to do such and such. And you give them that rough estimate. And then they pass out. Oh, I had no idea it was going to cost that much. And you say, okay, well, goodbye, and you leave. You just walk away?
No.
Well, you start negotiating, right?
Well, first of all, I never give a rough estimate.
You give a good estimate.
Yeah, we tell them, this is what it's going to
cost.
This
is exactly what it's going to cost.
And it will produce X amount of energy.
Yeah.
And here, so you can have the Cadillac.
Mm-hmm.
You can have the Buick, or you can have the Volkswagen 67 Bug. And they will all produce. They will get you there, but they will get you there with different efficiencies. And
And you know, you've asked me to come out here. I've been out here twice. I've given you estimate. It's really true. You really want this, right? Yes. So we're just now haggling about price. Yeah. And we're haggling about what we can add or take off that will get it down to where you're willing to buy it, right? Yeah. Some people would say, well, okay, I'll see you later. Goodbye. And you just lose that sale, right? You don't want to have that happen. That's negotiation. So that's what you do. Albert Einstein says that it's insanity of doing the same thing over and over again, expecting different results. Albert was a smart guy, so we can take that with that's true. Richard says, stupidity is not doing what's known to work or what's good for you. That's not, if you know something is good, will work, and it's good for you, and you're not doing it, that's just plain stupid. I can't think of any other way to describe it but that. So here are your options when people show up and they do these things and say, well, I've decided not to do that just yet. You can give up. You can succumb to life's greatest temptation, which is to settle for less. And I hope you don't do that one. Or you can ask for help. What we want you to do is ask for help, because help is available. We know how to overcome some of these issues. Because it's not hopeless. There are things that can be done to remedy the situation that, in terms of negotiation. Let's talk about strategy. Who can you describe your strategy? No one hardly I know very well can do this. It's describing your strategy. What is strategy anyway? Well, this is what strategy is. It's the way in which you plan on matching what you do best and like with the customers who you plan on reaching. That's strategy, folks. There's nothing mysterious about that. If you can match, plan ways to match this with that, you're done. And isn't that marketing? Pretty much. The details, your strategy has got to establish truly desirable values and benefits. Because what do you sell? Do you sell the products and services that you offer? Is that what you sell? No, it's not what you sell. What you sell is benefits. The windows and doors make the place look better. They make the power, the PG&E bill go down. The clean carpeting and furnishings and so forth and all the water damage makes the house presentable again, so when grandma comes over, she likes it, and we want that. That's what we're selling. So we got to talk about this. Second part, this strategy, once you have it, has to be executed nearly flawlessly most of the time. In other words, you can't do it well on Monday and then not do it again for 3 weeks. You have to execute, implement. Once it works, do it a lot. Or why would you bother to even figure out what works? You're just wasting your time, so don't do that. Number three, it has to identify and clarify what not to do, which we've been talking about. I'm not going to do this stuff anymore. I'm not crawling under any more houses. Yeah, I'm not gonna do the little teeny projects unless I'm pretty sure that later on they will lead to something more substantial. It has to result in some collection of integrated actions that reinforce one another. This reinforces this, this reinforces this, this leads to that, and all of these things I can now sell. One of the reasons why Scott and I are writing books is because the books reinforce other things that we do or want to do. So there is some connection between those things. They're not completely distinct from one another. It needs to drive continuous improvement because there's always feedback which says, you know, these things are now popular. People are buying these things in droves. Yes, maybe there's some federal stimulus money headed this way which helps people purchase those things. That's fine. During the period of time when the money's coming into town, we're going to concentrate on getting as much of it in our pockets as we can. So that will drive continuous improvement or changes in strategy. And has to secure desired results most of the time because there's nothing more frustrating than having a wonderful strategy, so we think, implementing it on time, and so forth and so on, and having it not do anything. That just makes you crazy, makes you nuts. And it has to please you immensely, or again, you're not following your passion. You may have a good job, but what's the fun of it? Why would you want to do that for the rest of your life? You know, when we're children, between the ages of 5 or 6 and about 18, our main daytime activity during the 9 months of the year is called school. And we go to school. Then after school, we come home and supposedly do a little homework, and then go to school again the next day. But as adults, our primary daytime activity is called working. And when we're little kids, if we're doing something, little bitty kids, playing, like 4 or 5 years old, not going to school, and if we're playing at something and we don't like it, what do? We stop and play at something else. We don't keep doing things we can't stand doing. And yet as adults, sometimes we have to, but we don't want to plan our lives that way. That would be ridiculous. No one would want to do that. So that's what the strategy must do. To refine your marketing plan, remember winners do what losers won't. They figured out the stuff that might be difficult to do, and they formulated the habit of doing those hard to do things to try to get them out of the way as early as possible in the day or the week. They do them anyway. This is the truest, biggest truth there is about success. Yes, there are things that are unpleasant, that they're difficult, we have to do them, but we have to get them out of the way. Now, who's this guy? That's his name, Sun Tzu. Remember him, 6th century BC, we've talked about him before. He said this: a victorious army wins its victories before seeking battle. That means before you commit the army to the field, you figure out already ahead of time how you're gonna win. So you know the winning is just pro forma exercise and it's just something you do. It'd be silly to go to battle and his work like that. It'd be silly to just start a business without thinking about what you want to do, or I'm going to change my marketing without thinking about how. Yeah, you want to think about these things before you do them. How? By planning better and by taking sensible action proactively. What's proactively mean, Larry? What's proactively mean?
Thinking ahead.
Yeah, not reacting, but being ahead of the game. Ahead of the game, right. Okay. Plans are only as good ideas unless they immediately generate into hard work. Peter Drucker said that. Your plans are only good ideas unless they immediately degenerate into hard work. It does take work to make work happen. So what to do? Well, we've talked about this before. One of the things you can do is you can keep talking to your existing customers. And who would not want to do that? I will guarantee you, I don't make a lot of guarantees, if you consistently talk with your customers, you will generate additional income. Anybody disagree with this? You can't disagree with this, it's the truism. It costs practically nothing except for time, and time is precious, so it does cost us time. But we'd be foolish not to do some of this, don't you think? This is why Ron is on the road, going out to see his medical clients and his clinics. He's already established relationships with them. May not have seen him or talked to him for a while, but he knows that if he keeps this up, the phone will ring back at the office. Orders will come in over the fax machine, and they'll make more money. Please figure this out. So what else? Well, here are some other things you can do to help market. You can put on some kind of an event.